Hello guys, kumusta, kumusta, kumusta. Welcome sa atuang session number 7. Continue ta sa atuang licensure examination review. Okay guys, so atuang sugdan karon guys dito ata mo focus gamay sa vocabulary, building vocabulary guys. So again, multiple choice test na siya. And you can pause the video from 3 to 5 seconds para inyo ma-figure out again ang answer. So, English guys, welcome to this channel. And if you are new, please subscribe and hit the bell for my future uploads. So, let's go. So number one, this car won't start. Let us call Danny because he's an old hand at repairing cars. So an old hand means old hand. A, reliable person. B, a trustworthy person. C, an experienced person. And D, an industrious person. The answer, guys, is we have an experienced person. Old hand means an experienced person. So just remember that one, guys. Next is we discussed issues that people are so vociferous about. A, licensed. B, hesitant. C, despairing. D, clamorous. The word to be unlocked is vociferous. Answer is clamorous. Okay. Clamorous na siya, guys. Remember lang, familiarize the word and repeat, repeat aron mahimo siyang habit, guys. So number three, it's the experiment yielded valuable results because the researcher was extremely scrupulous. Sounds like familiar, yeah? Or not familiar to you? Scrupulous. A, attentive to details. B, self-sacrificing. C, critical of one's work. And D, hard working. Rabag mingon ka nga. Scrupulous raman ka na siya. Siya isang scrupulous guy. Ayan guys. So, scrupulous means, ang ibig sabihin yan guys, is attentive to details. Meaning you are after of details. Detalyado. Taong detalyado. Number four. Hardened criminals rarely feel any compunction for their acts. So, decode natin guys. Compunction. The word is compunction. A, remorse. B, justice. C, joy. And D, deference. Yan guys, the answer is remorse. Compunction meaning remorse. Okay. Next, teachers recapitulate. Ito guys, para familiar, very familiar lang to guys. Recapitulate, recap their lessons before dismissing the class. A, remember. B, restrain. C, reiterate. D, retest. Recap, recapitulate yan guys. So answer natin dyan guys is reiterate. Reiterate. Parang sort of review lang guys. Recap. Number 6, which word is nearest in meaning to the capitalized words? Or word lang yan guys. Word natin is contemptuous.
Jose was contemptuous of the effects of the efforts of his rival to show greater ability. Contemptuous or contempt. A. Appreciative. B. Deep in thought. C. Scornful. And D. Angry. The word is contemptuous. Answer natin yan, guys, is scornful. Next, we have, how can unity in this organization be achieved? Grammar to, guys. A. Each have their own ideas about unity. Kung paano gagamitin natin ang each, guys, ha? B. Each had his own ideas about unity. C. Each have his own ideas about unity. And D. Each has his own ideas about unity. Indefinite pronoun, guys. Each. The answer is letter D. Each has his own ideas about unity. Ito, guys, tingnan natin bakit ito ang answer. A, hindi pwede kasi each have ang ginamit niya, hindi pwede yan. Dito, B, had din ang ginamit niya, hindi yan, hindi din pwede kasi sa question natin, sa stem ng question natin is can ang ginamit ito. Dito, present tense. So, hindi pwede, had is past tense, hindi siya match. D, each have, again, each have, hindi rin pwede. So, the nearest answer dito is letter D, each has. Grammatically correct. Oo. Pero, bakit naging mayroong his dito, guys? Ito, his. Sa ngayon, na gender sensitive kasi tayo. So, dapat bigyan yan or lagyan yan ng his or her. Oo. Pag may ganyan na mga ano, guys, option. So, that is the correct one. Next tayo, guys. Number 8. If you had come to theater last night, you blank the play. A. Would enjoy. B. Will have enjoyed. C. Will enjoy. D. Would have enjoyed. Topic nito, guys, is past perfect. Past perfect. Diyan mga perfect tenses natin. So, the answer is letter D, would have enjoyed. Again, guys, bakit? Kasi ang stem naman natin dito is if you had come. Past perfect yan. So, ang kambal yan, guys, ang kasunod na naman dyan na tense of the verb is would have enjoyed. Okay? Would have enjoyed. Hindi pwedeng maging would enjoy. Hindi pwede. Present kasi ito. Futurity of the action. Or yes, pwede rin sa futurity of action yan. Would enjoy. Hindi pwede yan kasi dito nag-had na. Meron ng had. Had come. Will have enjoyed, hindi din yan pwede. Oo, hindi yan pwede kasi will yung ginamit. So, will enjoy, hindi din yan pwede. So, dito tayo, yes, so would have. Ang tambal ng had come. Okay, number 9. The students never cheated on the examination. Okay, topic nito, guys, is tag questioning. A, is there? B. Do they? C. Didn't they? And D. Did they? Again, guys, that is tag question. Tag question to. So, the answer is, we have did they. Okay, and guys, bakit ganyan naman yan? Yung A natin, elimination gamit natin, guys. Ha? Elimination. Question. Pwede ba to? Hindi, pwede ito kasi is dadaan dyan guys. Oh. Mayroong is dyan. So, pag may is dyan, hindi yan pwede. So, dito tayo kasi students naman ang pinag-uusapan dyan. So, do they? Do they? Pwede ba yan? Do they? Hindi rin pwede. Because the students never cheated on the examination. Do they? Hindi pwede. Si do ang ginamit dito guys, present tense to. So, dito is verb natin is past form. Hindi pwede. Okay. Letter C. Didn't they? Pwede ba to? Didn't they? Hindi rin pwede yan guys. Kasi may never na dito. Negative na to. Kasi sa tag questioning is, pag ang stem ng sentence natin is negative, ang question form, ang nakadaan dito guys is, pag negative dito, dito is positive. Pag positive naman dito, walang negative, dito is negative. Like didn't, yan. Don't. So dito, this is the nearest one, did they. Dito, yan ang pinaka nearest. Kasi, did match siya sa tense of the verb dito cheated. Okay? Then, yan lang guys. Simple lang yan. So, let's go. Number 10. Which while expresses a contrast? Okay, keyword natin dito guys. Pagbugan siya is contrast. So, hanapin natin sa mga options kung meron bang contrasting idea. Tingnan natin sa letter A. While waiting for them, let's have some coffee first. Meron ba? Contrasting ba? B. The farmers are very hopeful while walking from the province to the city. Meron bang contrast or opposing statement dyan? C. She's taking a shower while her mother is cooking breakfast. And D, I am a pessimist while he is very optimistic. Okay. Take time guys. Kung saan ang contrasting idea dyan. Familiar naman. So, the answer is, I am a pessimist while he is very optimistic. Pessimist guys or pessimism, ito yung taong nag-iisip negatively, and optimistic or optimistic person, ang taong nag-iisip ng positive. Yan. Number 11. When will Miss Rezon retire? Soon, I think. She blank for a long time. She'll probably retire next year. So, ito guys, progressive ang pinag-usapan dito. A. Have been working. B. Had been working. C. Has been working. And D. Is working. She blank for a long time. So, the answer this one guys is has been working. Okay. Sa letter A natin guys, hindi yan pwede. Kasi yung subject natin dito is she. Third person singular yan. Hindi pwede. Dito, had been, hindi rin pwede yan. Kasi, yung progressive natin dito is past. Hindi past ito. Now, the statement is present form, I think, dito. Meron, I think. Meron future. So, hindi posible na ang progressive natin ay had or had been working. Letter C ay ito guys, parang pwede. Parang pwede kung hindi mo pa alam yung sagot. At saka letter D. So, the nearest answer dito is C or D. So, yung C ang pinakamalapit. Why? Because has ito eh. She has been working for a long time. This is present perfect progressive. So, ito ang pinaka-exact na answer. Hindi ito pwede kasi magiging yung pangyayari is ngayon. No? Ngayon lang. So, hindi pwede yan. So, the correct answer is letter C. Number 12. For thousands of years, rice black a staple food for many people? A. Is. B. Had been. C. Was. And D. Has been. Same lang to guys. Same principle of item number 11. Rice. Okay. Answer is has been. So rice has been a staple food for many people. Number 13 guys. The air around us. Okay, ito. Masaya to. A. Both contains oxygen and water. B. Contains both oxygen and water. C. Both contain oxygen and water. D. Contain both oxygen and water. Parang malapit lang sila lahat, guys. Anong answer mo dyan? So, answer dyan, guys, is letter. We have letter C. Contains both oxygen and water. So, letter C. Contains. Ah, no, it's not letter C, guys. May I correct? Contains letter B yan, ito. Ito ang correct answer niyan, guys. B. Letter B yan. Yan. Contains both oxygen and contains both oxygen and water. So automatically guys, mangyayari dito, bakit ganyan ang answer is the air around us. So air ang pinag-uusapan dito guys, ay air, singular. So automatically that requires singular also, a singular verb, which is contains. Again, we go back to the rule that the verb, the singular verb, is with S. Contains both oxygen and water. Okay? Hindi ito pwedeng letter A, guys. Ito. Yes. Ito, hindi ito pwedeng letter A. Both contains. Hindi yan pwede because that's grammatically not correct. Kasi both ang pinag-uusapan. Both contains, hindi pwede. Both two. Two kasi. Then dito, both contain, wala yan. Hindi pwede to, wala to. Both contain, oxygen. Tapos air ang pinag-uusapan eh. And D, both contain, contain both, wala rin. So, yan guys. Yan lang ang technique. So, number 14, what comment should be avoided so as not to discourage learners? What comment? A. Good work. B. You're being lazy again. C. You've got it. And D. Good try. What's the answer, guys? The answer is... We have... Letter D. Good try. And that is... yung estudyante if nagkamali, so sabihan mo lang na good try, good try, to avoid discouragement. Okay, number 15, who is considered the most outstanding among Filipino playwrights in English? Filipino playwrights, guys. A. Carlos P. Romulo. B. Leon Maria Guerrero. C. Severino Montano. And D. Wilfredo Maria Guerrero. Ito guys, basically this is under literature. The answer is Carlos P. Romulo. He is the Filipino playwright considered to be an outstanding playwright in English. Okay, guys, there is always a power in declaration. It's always. Okay, so you will pass the licensure exam. I declare it na ngayong darating na licensure examination 2020, papasa ka. Ikaw ay papasa at magiging isang guro. Okay, So guys, God bless. Salamat sa pakikinig. Salamat. Thank you for watching this video. If you have forgotten to subscribe, you may subscribe this channel if you like it. And see you on my next upload. Mabuhay Mindanao, Mabuhay Philippines.